good enough, I hope. Hello, Internet. This is Olin from What I'm Listening To. I hope you all are continuing to stay safe, stay healthy, keeping those hands nice and clean, you know the drill. I'm here yet again in an undisclosed room here at Amoeba Music, and today of all days is actually Record Store Day drop number 2. Why they needed to do a second one, I don't know, but they did. So in celebration for Record Store Day, I decided to pick up a good amount of new additions here in this bag, and well, we're gonna talk about them. So let's waste no more time, let's dive right in and see what we got. The first CD I have for you today, this is a collaboration between Joel Ford and Daniel Lopatin. I randomly stumbled across this the other day, and basically I got it just because Daniel Lopatin, aka Wenatrix Point Never, is attached to the project. I'm also just a huge fan of his collaboration album with Tim Hecker, so I figured I could use more Daniel collaboration albums in my life. This one's actually really cool because it leans more into the vaporwave future funk sound, which I've been very addicted to lately. Also, I think the cover of this really shows what to expect on this album. It's like passing out in front of your TV while it plays whatever it's playing, commercials, television shows, etc. So this should be a very fun album to listen to from start to finish. I'm excited to indulge in this, and maybe I'll fall asleep while listening to it just to embody what this guy's going through. All the way from emergency room. Ambulance inertia. I'm okay, although I'm being loud. Voices are going away. The next CD I have for you today, I have Morbid Saint's album, Spectrum of Death. This one I just happened to find in the employee recommendation section in the metal area, and I was just kind of fascinated by it, not because of this cover, but actually, this back cover here. If you look at this picture, these guys look like they're between the ages of 12 and 15 years old, which I think is hilarious. And the fact that, according to my coworker here, it's a cult thrash death classic, I had to know more about it. So I gave it a listen, and well, I ended up really digging it. Only 8 tracks long, but those 8 tracks are extremely brutal, fast-paced, super, super cool. The opening track, Lock Up Your Children, immediately grabbed me, and from there I just knew I had to buy this CD. So adding more thrash metal into my collection here, really, really great record, and highly recommend anybody check it out. Next up, I have a bit of a rarity here. This is Nine Inch Nails' CD, Still. I talked about this album a long time ago in some Berkeley Buys video. I had purchased this album alongside with their live album. It was packaged together in this limited edition box set. And I bought that box set specifically for this release. What this is this weird one-off, I guess it's an album, an EP, maybe it's just a mini album, but it's a one-off release consisting of very soft piano-based ambient tracks. Some of these songs are actually from the album Fragile, just done in a more ambient fashion rather than the heavy industrial fashion. And the other reason I was attracted to this title is, well, it's a rare CD, and you know me, I do love my rarities. But I've never actually seen this released as a standalone album. The version I have, like I said, is packaged together with the live album. So I couldn't help but to pick this one up just to have in my collection. It's not that I have anything against the live album, but I do like the idea of having this as its own standalone CD. So this is a really, really cool release. I was very excited to stumble across it here at work, and definitely recommend checking it out if you like Trent Reznor's more ambient, softer works. Okay, that does it for all the used titles. These next titles are all brand new, still in their shrink wrap. Probably won't open these up in this video because I only have so much time to film this. But starting things off, the first CD I have for you today, this is Rudimentary Peni's Death Church. The only reason I bought this is because one of my coworkers recommended it to me. He's really into a lot of goth and industrial music from the 80s, and we got to talking about all the bands from that time, and he brought these guys up. He prefaced that they're not necessarily a goth band, but they're pretty goth adjacent, at least in his eyes. So he played me a clip from a song off of this album, and I was sold immediately. I really don't know anything about this band at all, but based on that song clip alone, I know I'm going to enjoy this. But I will have to do some more research on the album and the band as a whole while I'm listening to this. Very excited to experience this from start to finish. Staying on the topic of punk, next up I have a Dystopia CD. This is their album, The Aftermath. I kept seeing this CD float around in the punk section, and there was just something about the cover I thought was really cool. In fact, before I really looked this up, I honestly thought this was a metal record rather than a punk record. And even looking at the font on here, kind of looks like it'd be a nu metal album. But as it turns out, it's more on the crust punk grindcore side of things, something I'm not quite as familiar with. But I figured, let's check it out. It's record store day, let's buy some stuff, and this one was the last copy in store, so I was happy to grab that. So I'm looking forward to cracking this one open and just hearing how brutal it is. It should be really fun. Okay, straying away from the heavy stuff, let's move on to something a little more soulful. This is Hiatus Coyote's album, Choose Your Weapon. This is a band that's been on my radar since their newest album came out, but I really didn't know anything about them up until then. And it's funny because we file them in the rock section at our store, but I would argue that they should go in the soul section. These guys are just straight up a neo-soul band, and their music is excellent. I was very excited to get a copy of this album in stock because I've heard a couple tracks off of it, and I thought they were just so, so good. So I'm happy to get the whole thing, all 18 tracks, so there's a lot on here. And we'll see, I might end up picking up the newest album, but until then, I'll be listening to this one a lot. Direct to the old Navajo by the fire. Wish we were burning old design. Next up, I have some new music from this year. This is an album by a band called Horse Girl. I didn't know a single thing about this album until we played it in store. Whenever there's new releases, sometimes I check them out just to get educated, and sometimes they just slip under the cracks because I'm too busy listening to other stuff. But this one came out and we ended up playing it in store on the new release day, and I was immediately captivated by it. I loved how hazy and kinda shoegazy it sounded, but also was very melodic and a little on the grungier side of things. It just sounded really, really cool. So after listening to this a handful of times at home, I decided I need to buy a copy of this CD. It was some really, really great stuff on here. And anyone interested in new music from this year, this one is definitely a highlight. Check this out, it's great. When a fly starts to make car, speaking of new music, next up I have The Smiles album, A Light for Attracting Attention. This is one of those albums where the digital release came out about a month before the physical release, which as of the recording of this video, this came out yesterday, and I just could not help but to pick up a copy. As generic as it might be, I do really enjoy Thom Yorke and Radiohead and all that stuff. He just has a way of composing great somber electronic rock music. But what's cool about this is the drummer from Sons of Kemet drums on this album, and it just adds a more jazzy influence to the music. We listened to this in store, and I honestly really enjoyed it, and I'm really looking forward to listening to this with a pair of headphones. Alright, the last item I have for you today is actually a Record Store Day drop. This is Wilco's newest album, Cruel Country. It's funny being a CD lover on Record Store Day because, well, as the title suggests, it's all focused on vinyl. And not that I have anything against vinyl, but I just happen to like CDs a little bit more. And with every drop, there's at least one CD that comes out, but there really haven't been a lot over the years that I've just really been that interested in picking up. But on this day, there was actually one CD that came out that I was very excited for, and it was this one. As some of you might already know, Wilco is one of my all-time favorite bands. The album actually dropped digitally sometime in April or May, with the intention of the full release coming out on CD and vinyl later on. But because pressing plants are having a hard time keeping up with demand, they were not really sure when they were gonna put out the proper record and CD release. So instead, they were able to put out the pre-release version of this album with just kind of a generic white background and black text. But it still has the album in all its glory, which I'm totally okay with. I've been holding off on buying it digitally because I knew it was going to be coming out in a physical format at some point. And yeah, I guess I could wait for the full version to come out with the album art and all. But A, I'm impatient and I want it now. And B, this is still a pretty cool, unique thing to own. And just as far as the music goes on this one, this is actually an interesting release because it shows the band going back to their country roots. In a way, I kind of see this album as the spiritual successor to Being There, which is my personal favorite Wilco record, partly because it does return to that country sound, and also because it's a double album with two discs, 21 tracks in total. But what's also interesting about this album is I feel like there's a bit of influence from everything they've done in their discography. It's got the country twang, it's got the Americana influence, it's even got some of that experimental pop stuff that they did during the Summer Teeth and Yankee Hotel Foxtrot era. It's overall just a really, really good album. This one's easily one of my favorite releases of 2022, and I am so very excited to finally own a copy. I will be listening to this a lot over the next couple weeks, so shout out to you, Wilco, for putting this out, and I will still most likely buy the full album art version whenever that comes out.
Oh death, I was just getting dressed. Place is a mess, I was hoping you'd forget. I can feel you in my chest, I can feel you in my chest.
Alrighty then, internet, that does it for me. Thank you all so very much for watching. If you have any new additions you've added to your collection, whether it's vinyl, CDs, cassettes, or even stuff from this Record Store Day drop, let me know what they are. Leave a comment down below. And if you also like this video, be sure to hit that subscribe button. They'll show me the support and I'll love your face for it. And you can also follow me on Instagram for even more music. I post a new album on there semi-frequently, talk a little bit about it, and it gives you a bit of an insight of what else is in my collection. So thank you all so very much for watching. This is Olin from What I'm Listening To, signing out. Goodbye.